Do we, I mean, want to talk about your show that's wonderful and beautiful and delightfully crazy?
Yes, we must.
So season two, season one was batshit crazy. You have to kind of up the game, I would think, going into season two. Season two is up and running, obviously, already. Give me a sense of like what you wanted to see in season two, what your expectations were, and what's been delivered so far.
I think we're extraordinarily excited to see some of the characters that we'd been anticipating and waiting to see, but they didn't quite allow us, or they didn't want to. They wanted to do the prequel in the first season, so it was wonderful to finally get to see some of the other characters from the comic from Garth's mind.
When I talked to a bunch of you last year, and there are always the expectations, obviously, in a beloved property, having like won over most, if not all, of the fans and getting, you know, the ratings and the reviews, do you feel kind of a relief going into season two, like more confidence on the set, or?
I found there was a bit more pressure, actually, because we've done all right now. Like last year, it was like we didn't know whether we'd get the second series, and I think coming into the new series, there's a little bit of pressure there because you don't want to let anyone down at this stage now. Yeah. If we'd done a good job the first time round, and
right.
I think there's a feeling of ease there in the first series. Whereas the second series comes along and it is expected of you to do well, and if you fuck it up, man, you know.
Second album.
Boom.
Nice to meet you.
Is that one of the worst
handshakes?
I want to see that in slow motion.
A mildly sexual handshake.
I need to lie down now.
Don't ever do it again. God's sake.
No, that's a meme now. Congratulations, your first meme. We've done it. So give me a sense. A few episodes at least have run already. I know what's to come in this season. Is there something you're excited for the fans to see as we progress through season two?
Should we ruin? Let's ruin it.
Let's start at the end and go backwards. Yeah.
Okay.
Let's ruin the end and go backwards.
Yeah, yeah.
You've been doing.
There's something happens at the end. Should I say that?
There's something happens at the end.
Oh wow! Thanks for that spoiler.
That's someone gets killed. Right?
Something happens at the end. Yeah.
Really? Yeah. Are we talking about the show or just in life right now? That's just like a metaphorical.
At the end of this interview. Yeah.
What's going to happen?
The show finishes.
To me,
there's a huge reveal at the end. Something happens, which means you're going to be introduced to a character that I think a lot of the people who love the original material have been dying to meet. That's the bit I can't say, and you make me say it, and then I ruin it.
I was getting worried when Dominic's the one that's like the actual most on message guy in the group. Then you're like, oh, this is not a good thing.
So true.
Very polished.
Are you still in production right now, or are you done with the season?
We finished it.
Yeah. Ruth, you had a pretty good year since I spoke to you last time. Has she changed season two? Or has she gone?
Personality-wise.
Yeah, personality-wise. Yeah.
No.
She's not looking any of you in the eye anymore.
Sucks the life.
You can't speak to her.
Violent.
You have to look down.
Aggressive.
Sexually, very aggressive.
Wow. Yeah.
Okay. Just like she expects it.
Expects what?
Well, whatever it is, I'm not giving it to them.
So there you go.
Would you like to own up and apologize for what you've become?
We've realized how small and shifty your hands are as well. We never realized.
He said that to me. He went, why are they there? You don't even need them. They're too small for them to be necessary.
It's pointless.
Let's talk. It's useless to try to be coherent with this interview. So let's just talk about some fun things. Game of Thrones, everybody always is obsessed with. Any Game of Thrones fans here?
I like Ewan. He's a nice lad.
Okay.
Yeah. I've never watched it. But I reckon I'd really dig it, man, because I'm into all the mythologies. Is he dead?
Yeah, he died.
Mr. Misery here.
But I saw him about 5 minutes ago.
Dead.
He died. Just of exposure out here in Comic-Con.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Mm-hmm. He died of fatigue.
So no bold predictions for how it's going to end since you've never seen an episode.
It'll end when it finishes.
Thank you. Thanks for that.
Somebody will die, I reckon.
Yeah, I would put my money on it. Again, are we talking about this interview or Game of Thrones?
I'm still talking about the end of this interview.
Our careers will die at the end of this interview. This is the only thing that's dying here.
I'm just with going you guys back to the end.
It's okay.
Can we save this interview? Can we put it back?
No, it's too late. It's over. It's gone. We hit the iceberg and it's going down.
Because people will see the others that we've done and messed up. We've got a collection of this now.
Thank you guys, as always, for stopping by.
Really?
I have to say that contractually. I don't actually mean it. Check out Preacher Season 2.
I don't actually mean it.
And enjoy your Comic-Con.
Thank you.
Thanks, man.